Please be seated. Greetings to Pastor and Sister Allen, greetings to our senior deacon Brian, all the other officers, saints of the Most High God, extra special greetings to the members of the Dixon's family, all the brethren, all the visitors. I greet you all tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. We're here to remember the life of our dear brother Dixon. We're here to give God thanks for his life. We're not here for a night of relaxation and sit and to reminisce. We're here for a night of praise and worship. Amen? Amen. The Bible says we weep not as them that have no hope. Amen? And this hope that we have, we cherish not in vain. He was baptized in Jesus' name. He received the gift of the Holy Ghost. And that is enough for us to give God thanks for. That is enough for us to worship God for. Amen? So I don't want you to get too relaxed. Because we are going to go hard and go home in the name of Jesus. So could you all stand everywhere? Look across to your neighbor and tell him it's good to see you. Come on, look across to somebody else and tell them it's good to see you. Come on, man, so first, I'm sure you have not seen them for a while. Tell them it's good to see you. Hallelujah. Sing praises unto God, sing praises.
Hallelujah.
Sing praises. Bless the name of Jesus. The first item of the program to come with is tribute. Bless the name of Jesus.
Yes. When I'm low in the spirit, I cry, Lord, lift me up, for I want to go higher in Thee. So
praise the Lord one more time? Can we praise the Lord, everybody? Praise the Lord Jesus. I count it as a great privilege. Praise the Lord Jesus to stand here to give a tribute. Praise the Lord Jesus to Brother Carlton's family tonight. Praise the Lord Jesus is immediate family and church brethren. Praise the Lord Jesus. I have known him to be a very quiet, humble stalwart. He was a foundation member. Praise the Lord Jesus. From I was in this church from I was about 15 years old. Praise the Lord Jesus. Only 5 years. And I've grown and seen Brother and Sister Dixon. They're an example of what a good married couple should look like. Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise the Lord, everybody. Yes, praise the Lord. And Brother Carlton was very quiet. He was not a talkative person at all. Praise the Lord Jesus. A very handsome man. Praise the Lord Jesus. He always sits right over there. Praise the Lord Jesus. And whenever Pastor Allen would call on him to give a testimony, he would always stand and give his little testimony, even though he was stammer. Praise the Lord Jesus. And you know, sometimes stammer people don't like to talk. No, not true. Praise the Lord Jesus. But he was always obedient. He would sit. And if Pastor Allen asked him to stand and testify, he would just share his testimony. Praise the Lord Jesus. And he, sometimes when I always talk to him, like before or after service, praise the Lord, he always says, Sister Swan, not just the knee, man, the knee, the foot. Praise the Lord Jesus. I'm listening to him say, Brother Carlton, you can't have foot and wife have foot at the same time. And he would just laugh. Praise the Lord Jesus. But I visited him sometime ago. I did not visit him this time around. Praise the Lord. I was so busy and so much on my plate. But when I visited both of them some time ago, praise the Lord Jesus, I spoke to them and he was talking about God.
Amen.
He was always talking about God. Praise the Lord Jesus. I can encourage family members tonight that he had what it takes to make it in. So if you don't have what it takes tonight, if you want to see him again, because I know that there is hope, praise the Lord, you have to travel that same old pathway. Praise the Lord Jesus. You got to get yourself baptized in the name of Jesus and receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, and not just that, live for the Lord. I can tell you that this was a man. You know that everybody, the song said, may the life I live. Not everybody can go to the pulpit and preach one big sermon.
Amen.
But you see, the life that you live, somebody said, little is much when God is in it. And if he was an humble little man, a very, very humble little man in his whole way, praise the Lord Jesus. And I'm sure that his life would have impacted so many persons in so many ways. Praise the Lord Jesus. I know what it feels like to lose a loved one. Praise the Lord Jesus. I know that it is not an easy road and it's not going to get better. And maybe perhaps you may never get over it, because I don't get over it. Praise the Lord Jesus. But God is able to carry you through. He's carrying me through. I don't get over it as yet. I'm still going through the process, but I know that he can carry. He's carrying me, so I know that he can carry you through also. Praise the Lord Jesus. I am just going to sing number 50. Praise the Lord Jesus, to encourage our hearts that death hath no terror for the blood bought one. When you are baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost, we have a lively hope that we cherish not in vain. And that's why we cry. I'm not going to say saying or not to cry. Cry if you must. I would implore you to bawl. Because I needed to do some of that when my mother died. And I found myself now bawling. Praise the Lord Jesus a lot. I bawl, especially night before last night. I never even know myself. Praise the Lord Jesus. I was hiding it. I did not want Greg and Shan to see me. Praise the Lord Jesus. So I took my little ball into my own corner. Praise the Lord Jesus. And then I dry up. I said, chuck. And come on back again. So that's how it feels like. Praise the Lord Jesus. But when you remember that you have a lively hope, sometimes you say, God, oh, my mother does dead so. And then the time comes and say, God, you could have given her 20 more years. Like she just lived to see 84. You just take her so and it's that. But praise the Lord Jesus, brother Dixon, I lived a life. Yes, pass it. The 3 score years that he's been gone through, 4 score years. So we should be celebrating his life tonight. And so we're here. We are here to give you strength and courage. Praise the Lord Jesus, that you can go through. Somebody say, ride out your storm. I am not a singer, praise the Lord Jesus, but I am just going to sing. Praise the Lord Jesus. 2 verses of this song. Death has no terror for the blood part one. Oh, glory, hallelujah to the Lamb. The most victory of the grave is won.
Worship God. Amen?
Amen.
Sometimes I go to pick up Brother Carlton and a
would instruct the librarian to how to sit in the vehicle. You know, go in, put in, back on first, then take time. I said, take your time. Don't be in any rush, man. Take your time. And when he comes into the house of the Lord, he tries to do the little that he can. So when we get into the presence of the Lord, we're here to worship Jesus. There's a thing going around now with food problem, people with food problem. I'm struggling with it too. So you're walking like a night going down and all of a sudden you need to take your side on the hand. So when you feel strength in your body, man, you're coming to the house of the Lord. Give God some praise and worship, amen? Because guess what? The old is feeling pain, the young is feeling pain. I was at school one day, Sister Allen, and when I was modeling like a nice walking down, all of a sudden my foot take me. I'll be happy, I'll go back inside and get something and band it up. And by the time I came out back outside, I saw the principal walking and happy. And I look, I saw another one holding my baby. Let's get the one holding back young people. So we have to give God praise. Once we have the chance, old feeling pain, young feeling pain. So every time I get the chance of praising, I will stand in the way, hallelujah. Lord, you brought me through sorrow.
Christian people. The Bible says every
friend. Before you leave a friend, bless the name of Jesus. The story is told of one man who was coming from a day yard one night. He and his sorority, his nephew, and while he was coming and walking, he heard a loud foot behind him, some loud footsteps behind him. And when he stopped and looked around, didn't see anybody. Kept on walking and he heard the footsteps loud, loud again behind him. Stopped and looked around and didn't see nobody. And when he stepped off again, the loud finally heard the steps loud, loud. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd." The person who can't say, answer back and say, "I'm feeling shepherd, shepherd too." I'm feeling shepherd, shepherd too. He run like he hear news. So you seek a friend before you need a friend. Amen? Yes. Bless the Lord Jesus. Is Chavelle here? Chavelle?
Pastor Allen, Sister Allen. All the saints of Warsop United Pentecostal Church. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm just here to sing a song. One of my dad's favorite songs. Praise the Lord. Thank you all for your prayers and condolences. Thank you. The chimes of life ring out the news, another day's through. Someone slipped and fall. Was that someone new? You may have, you may love, for added strength, your courage to renew. Do not be disheartened, I have news for you.
here in this memorial service for Carlton Dixon, you know, knowing him has been a great time. He's so kind, he's so friendly, he's always have an encouraged word for me. Each time I go to the house, he's always there smiling because of my appearance. He's always been happy. When he don't see me, he always asks my mom. You know, when Mary come up, he always wants to see me. I'm just missing him. You know, when I went inside of the room on weekend and I don't see him, I felt so sad. Because I will always have something to laugh about. He's always have something to tell me and to make me feel happy, especially if I'm down, he's always there with me. He always tried to say, I'm married, you want to leave this to be next grand people. And me know I know why we feel they walk with their pants on their body. Change come and no one wants to begin. He's always growing me like his own child. You know, I feel so appreciated when I'm around him, even Miss You. She always treats me like I am her own. You know, I'm feeling so comfortable, you know. But nevertheless, he's gone. And it is so sad. It is so sad when I wait to give him his tea. When I reach the world, there is no more colleague. No more colleague, but you know, I feel so heartbroken. I feel so bad. No, Kali is gone and he's no longer with us. But I know he finds rest. And I know his soul rests in peace. Wherever he is, I know that he is in a good hand. Praise God. I know where he's gone. He's resting in peace. Shall we praise the Lord? You just worship with me while I minister in song. Like a sheep sitting out on a tree, so rough and long, so far from home, and so
calling when I was 16 years old. Straight up, I was like 21 years old. Oh, forgive me. So, probably be my first boss before I lived in Canada. So, he's the one who helped me out to get to Canada, like, helped with my passport and those stuff. So, I don't want to say today, I want to say I'm giving him thanks, like always. When I come from Canada, I will visit him and sit down and have a little talk with him and those stuff. Miss you. You're a good wife and a good friend.
Amen.
And a good mother. Carlton is a good man to me and like a father to me. So I would say thanks, Carlton, and respect. And God bless you on your journey. Till we meet again.
Ever since I said, it was very small. And ever since I started, and I said to him, "What you want a piece of meat to?" So you're a preacher. He said, no, I'm a preacher. But I know it's better than a liar, a piece of meat to me. So you need to fix yourself up. Turn a new page, a page on the book of God and book. Bless the Lord Jesus. The Lord is calling you. Say, right unto your man, because you are strong. And then until you get used to Mike. Amen. So somebody who's used to Mike will be coming now, Deacon Brian, in Jesus' name. And you can be some meat when I make back. Come. Bless the Lord Jesus.
Spread the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
God is good.
Hallelujah.
And all of the time. Praise God. My soul magnify the Lord.
Amen.
And my spirit praise his name. Special greetings to Pastor Holly and Minister Holly. I think I've heard that this is a memorial service. I've never been into a memorial service. Praise God. I do lots of funeral. And I think memorial service is to talk about the persons, the person that passed. Since I came to Trelawny and be a part of the Pentecostal church, be a member of the Pentecostal church, I've known Brother Dixon and Sister Dixon. And there was a time we went to convention and I was traveling with Sister Dixon. Brother Woodfine, we were in our car. And the man was driving the car so fast. And being young and naive, don't understand the danger of speeding. I was there telling the man, take off the brake and keep meeting in the back. And I remember Sister Dixon, she prayed and said, Jesus Christ. I want to go back and tell him that was silly people. When we come to church and Brother Dixon, he's not a man of many words. So when he calls upon to do something, then you have to listen attentively. And as I heard somebody said, it's not the sermon that you preach. It's not the exaltation that you give. The Bible said in a great house, there are many vessels. They are vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor. And many people have called into the kingdom for different reasons. The life that you live you can have an impact on the people that is around you. Then, when, if you can look at the person and give them one word, and that one word ministering can bring them to Christ, then it worth more than giving them $1 million. Sometimes when I saw Brother Dixon, I would rub his head because he's a man who we are bothered. And sometimes he would look up at me and say, because you're taller than me. Yes. But this is the humor that he always have. And then for a man to live 90 something, I don't know. I heard somebody, I was asking my wife today. 93. For a man to live 93 years, that is a life that I live. And as I was sitting there, I was thinking and I was saying that if a person lives 90 something, 93, and then we come to a funeral service for that person, and somebody cried, then you are ungrateful. Yes, because no, it's not every first time you would hear of person. You would hear of person that died. Old, no, young is dead, dying. Old are dying. Everybody is in the dying line. I don't know why everybody is just dying to go to the cemetery. But I think we should celebrate the life of Brother Dixon. 93 years. And if a man lived 93 years, and then that man lost his way, then his head should have a head. Sound funny, not true? It sounds funny, man. Because Solomon really looked at it and said, listen, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. The whole duty of a man is to fear God. Your life is not consistent of the things that you are possessed. Because I passed by New Road since night. Me and my son, and when I look at the house, I love to see nice things, you know. Don't get me wrong, I love nice things. And I love to see nice souls. Yes, I love to see them. When I look at the house, that the man living there. And I was saying, God, what is that? Yeah, the man living in a very nice house. That is very good. Really good. And for all the young people that is in the house of the Lord tonight, stay with the Lord. For all the good things in this life is in Christ. Amen. Now when you look at Brother Dixon, I know the man living life, he might look simple. He might not be a man who is in the spotlight. But let us look at the foundation that Brother Dixon. All of us are living under foundation. All of us are building on the foundation, because I don't know where the church is coming from, but I realize to my knowledge, I understand that Brother Dixon, Sister Dixon, they are the foundation of the gospel. And they might not stand up and minister like others, but there are some names that here that talk about the present. Stalwart, Parsons, present, Stalwart. They are one of, Sister Dixon are one of the living Stalwart. Amen. Brother Dixon, Parsons, and Stalwart. Now, then look at what they accomplish. When you can stand, when I was sitting here and I was looking at a chandelier up here and I was saying, why nobody? It very look good, not you? It look good. Then if it wasn't for these people, we would not have this. We wouldn't have these facilities. They die for it. They fight for it. Yeah, they sweat for it. Now we can reap the fruit of it. So this is life that is well lived. You know, people live their life and after them, they don't impact nobody. People live their life, some people live their life and they accumulate all the things that this world has to offer. And they still don't impact anyone. If Brother Dixon had lost his way, he will have to stand and give an account. Look how many witnesses. Look how many witnesses are here to say yes. The theme that passed for our youth week. Same foundation. New generation. What is same foundation? And when my generation passed, it going to be the same foundation. And if another generation pass, it going to be the same foundation. Let us labor for the master from the dawn and setting till setting sun. Sister Dixon, how are you, sir? I was looking at you while you were coming in, and it has been a long time I haven't seen you. But it's not that I am looking by your house. But sometimes you know the work, you know. Right? And sometimes my work becomes far, far away. But sister, this you looking good. You seem to feel like you want to marry again. I don't want to call anybody name because I don't want to get any name. And I'm not going to look in a certain direction. But I remember I make a promise to few of them that I'm going to help them along the way. Right. But somebody might ask, how are you going to do it? I was telling a widow that didn't know I'm going to buy a house but for you.
Carl. Sir.
God bless you. In Jesus' name.
To be in the house of the Lord one more time. Greeting to Pastor Allen and Minister Allen, all the members of the Dixon's family. Praise the Lord. I am here.
Miss you.
Yes.
Chantal, oh my God, years, donkey years, schoolmate, and all of that. But because of death, understand what you're going through.
20 odd years ago, I lost my father. 1 year ago, I lost my mom. So I can imagine what you're going through. And so I can recall with Brother Dixon from a long time, from a little one, from a watch over Brother Dixon, ever sharp. Look at him, he could have dressed, you know? And when that man, he never started to walk, we can't walk like him. But you have a sort of walk. And when you have a knee hat on your head and you have a stick, look here, the man just looked up. I really, really admire this man in such a way. Because many young persons, they should take a leaf from this young man. That's a young man. Because 93, based on how he really carried himself. Trust me, I really admire him for that. God bless his soul. Praise the Lord at this time. I'll try and do this song. Praise the Lord.
My heart can sing.
Just borrowed for a while. The sea.
so glad to be a part of tonight's proceeding. And I remember Brother Carlton in a very happy way. I came into church like 37 years ago. And I met Brother Carlton. My husband used to work with him also. And the first time they were leaving to Canada, Brother Dixon leave his possession with my husband. Me and him down in Durham, bush, carrying down the lunch for the men and things like that. And from ever since, Brother Dixon took him. Myself and Minister Allen, Pastor Allen, Sister Nordy, we went down to the bottom house to serve Brother Dixon and Sister Dixon, Lord's Supper. It is very encouraging to me to visit this family. We visit them very often. The death of Miss Hilda, where they are praying a lot of us. And one day I remember Pastor Lynn said to me that I must call Miss Yu and tell her that we are coming to pray with them. I was calling Sister Dixon, but she did not answer, so I walked the road and went around there. And when I went there, she said to me, said, yes, you can come. But Carlton wanted to shave. And when I looked at Brother Dixon, he really wanted to shave. So I said to him, where is the shave? And Dr. Lee gave me the shave. And I did shave Brother Dixon. Because I want when Pastor Allen and Minister Allen go there, it looks good. And I noticed Brother Dixon, how he was well groomed coming to church. And I did not know that he was that age. Because he don't show that age. 93? 93? It's a blessing. It's a blessing, and I understand that they are coming from way back from the bamboo dirt church. And they are still here with us until Brother Dixon said goodbye. Isn't that a blessing? Give them a round of applause. Hallelujah. They did it. God kept them. God kept them. And I love that. Sister Dixon, keep holding on. Along with your daughters and your son. We will be bearing up you in our prayers, and whatever I can do to help, I'm going to do it. Amen. And before I go down, I just want to sing this song. Say, when the circle be unbroken. always told me to go and just check up on my Spartan. And most of the time, my Spartan can earn my money. You hear my colleague, my name, my name, we go over there. Make a call for it for me. You know, I miss you, you know. Make a call for it. You don't hear about Vinet, and no say. He loves Vinet. Not saying that Cheryl and Jeff and Kulin and the rest, no, but Vinet. Me and my Spartan, I want the secrets. So, I used to go by an Adventist church with my grandfather. But whenever time I come from church on a Saturday, I don't know why miss you always cook the thing. But every time it's cook that thing, my Spartan always make this point of duty. Anytime you go to the kind of church, I'll come back, hear my Spartan. Rona, come make my phone call with me. I'm in flight. And some passion is so bad, everything she cried for. I want him to ask and take him out, and he's going to ask her now. And so little Penny just stop crying. So here, my Spartan, Penny don't love nobody black. So, with saying that, miss you, I admire you over the years. Take care of my Spartan. Look here, it's a woman. Children, tonight I want to say that you have done well, you have taken care of your parents the best way you could, and you have a blessing awaiting you. I love my Spartan, I'm my little friend, my little Calibots, that. And when you hear me say Calibots, I call me and you come at the window and say, Rona, me and you know about that. Alright? July of last year, I went to look after him, and when I met him, he was so humble, was a nice person. He always talked about Vinet. Vinet, I'm here with child. No mess. when we look after him, it's always a thing, he said, Master Dad, don't think of me. And don't love me, just love Vinet. But when you think of Vinet, you just think of me because I'm in this space of Vinet. But I couldn't all be Mary. No matter what I do, I couldn't all be Mary and like nothing because Mary was her favorite. Is his favorite. And when we have this Vinet, we always say to my start and say, you're selling out, you know. Like a politician, but me can't take criticism like a politician. But you just sell out me and miss you. For Mary, we just come. I look a long day of video. But you have as Mary come. My Spartan don't want to see me and Mary, me and miss you, no, not call again. I just Mary.
White country.
Yeah, just that. So, we miss him a lot because he was a nice person and miss you. You're just like a mother to me. So I miss my Spartan a lot. And I was the last person to see him take his last breath. And I never afraid.
until now we're afraid. Father, come like in day, come like England and Canada to come back. So I'm just, we just come like there, wait to see, come back from Canada. Because I couldn't believe that I did it then. Even me put him and shake him and say, my father, I'm 30 years. He just go, hey. He said, watch out, I can't get it from here. And he said, I'm not frightened about them. And Miss Missy would come in and say, Carly, and Miss Missy, my Carly, I'm dead. He said, oh, dead. He said, we run for our glass and put your nose. And then see senior from said, Miss Missy, let me come back and kiss you. He said, no. He says, you're not beat ya. He said, no. He says, you're not that beat up there. He said, no. And Missy, she take over that room. He said, what are you going to let me? Man, you have to come with him. Catching that passenger like somebody tap me and say, yeah, yeah. Go back and break up yourself. Everybody can run. And they go back and stand up in the room. And I start to come back and she said, can you really then? And I say, yes. And they go back out again. Me just see her spinning and mom at all. And what? God give me the strength to brave up myself because I first never experienced this. But he gave me strength to brave up and keep you on the other one. He just said my thanks.
Can I praise God, everybody? Can I praise God, everybody? Hallelujah, hallelujah. You know, she did the talking, so I'm just going to sing. Let's do a verse, not three verses at this time. Hallelujah, cheers. Have your answer. God Christian. Thank you.
bless you all in Jesus' name. Amen.
God bless you all. This is my good friend. Come here, man. Come here. Hello, my.
Yes, please, you know. Yeah,
yeah,
friend, you
better
have yes, man.
You
ever
seen him? Let us praise the Lord. You know, when I come at this church, my Carlton is a very good man. I never seen him take something. He's a man who has been here, a smile on his face. You know, one time down the road, and he said, my Carlton didn't know. I think you know, and the train when I was there says, we shut it here, yeah. So I said, my Carlton, me you see a dead man, shut it here, yeah, man. And me and him grab a good laugh around me. My Carlton, he was a good man. I see you there. You know, sometimes we have some people in the church, and I said to the pastor, pastor, you know, she said, the sister one, lead a dress. Sister you. You know, the amount of sister, the amount of fat we need to give to sister for we are come to church and buy money.
That's good.
I'm going to tell nobody. Miss you, she's a good lady. I'm not telling the fact what she has said, what she has been done. It's like an empty man come from life now. So you see, there are times some people, some things, you know, people, you know, they talk about. She's a good lady, she's a mother. And there are lots of women in this world. But we have two ladies. She's one of them. May God bless everyone. And may his soul rest in peace.
Thank you, brother. Can we praise the Lord, everybody? Amen. Praise God. I'm really glad to be in the house of the Lord. I don't think I have much to say. Amen. But I'd like to sing this song, although I'm not a singer. Amen. Praise God. I'm going to ask us to help me sing it, because I don't know it's a good enough. But I'd like to sing it.
I thank God for our heritage, for our great men who tread the path and path, blood stains footprints.
Men who had traveled. Amen. Praise
praise God who set the foundation. Praise God. Amen. Brother Dixon, Carlton Dixon is my good friend. Amen. I could remember my mother told me that when the gospel came from Ulster Spring by Pastor Dawson, the late Pastor Dawson, I was very sick. I don't know if Sister Dixon knew about that, but my mother told me that I was very sick. My head was big. Looking at the nose now, was that time it big. Amen. But because of the late Pastor Dawson, Brother Dixon, Brother Lyndon Brissett, Brother Clement Campbell, my mother told me that she called in Pastor Dawson at her little house. Pastor Dawson bring Brother Carlton Dixon along, Brother Clement Campbell, Brother Lyndon Brissett to the house. There was no olive oil there, but Pastor Dawson said, what type of oil you have? It was the coconut oil. He said, give me. And all of them pray for me in Jesus' name. Amen. And I sung, I thank God for it must be something when the Lord has spared my life in time like this. Amen. And Pastor Dawson and Brother Carlton Brissett and Clement Campbell could pray for me so that I'm alive. And I'm alive for it. I could remember as a little boy running around here. Amen. The bishop came and he was the one who was perhaps situated at the foundation raiser. And Brother Carlton Dixon, he was there mixing the material. Amen. For the building. And I remember to the bishop, it's like they were not working fast enough. And he said, come on, Brother Dixon, mix up the material or thing like that. And then you know what happened? He started to work, but afterwards some tears started to fall from his eyes. Amen. It could be that he was tired. But he kept on working on the building. And the building is assured. Foundation, and you have it today to worship in. Amen. Praise God for our heritage. Between me and Brother Carlton, I tell you something. In the 70, amen, when I came from Kingston, the Lord called me from Kingston and I came from here from Kingston. But I was not a lazy man. And I started to work. And I remember Brother George, I went to a rich man field and started to work with that rich man for some yam head to plant. The man said he had some yam head. And he's going to sell all the yam head. I didn't have the money to buy the Yami. But I said to the man, I'm going to work for it, for the Yami. And after that, the man said to me, yes, you can get the Yami. Right? And I start to work with the man for the Yami. You know what the man do? Did that to me. The man calling a man from over Craig. And he sold the man 1,000 Yami. 1,000. And I am in the field just working for 200. And he would not give the 200 to me. Because he said, he don't sell 100 Yami. Okay. And I said, he gave me the money. He didn't rob me, he gave me the money. All right. And I go to Brother Carlton Dixon. And I said, I need some yam here to plant a field. Because I go to such and such a man. The man is dead now. Amen. But I'm not going to tell you the name because the man have children around. And you're going to say, is. Amen. Good. So, I went to Brother Carlton Dixon. And Brother Carlton Dixon placed something in my head. And until now, he's dead. But I have it in my head. Brother Carlton Dixon and Brother Roy, his name Roy, that's Mapun. Son. Simple shot. They look at me and they said, man, let me tell you something. Never you work for a rich man for young here. They are not going to give it to you. They are not going to give it to you. You understand? You know why they are not going to give it to you? They want you to be in their field all the days of their life. So when you buy young here, do what you must do. Go to a poor man. Buy it. Work for the man and buy the young. And until now, it rests with me. I work with Brother Carlton. And I have a fact of the Yami. Amen. But he teach me something before he died. Because I never know that. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So you might have it in your mind and you might too. Amen. Now listen. Brother Dixon. I've been a member of this church from in the 50s. In the 50s. I really cannot tell you the exact time looking on the book, because that first book it destroyed by somebody else. But from the 50s he being a member of this church. He has up and down, as all of us do. Praise God. But I can't tell you that one chunk. Amen. And I, Afafa, used to drive the chunk for my brother Carlton. Goes to market, he goes to market in St. Elizabeth. So I would drop him and afterward go back for him. There's one thing with Brother Dixon. We never tell the chunk. Finish the load off and you're ready to come up. He's not going to let you come up from Santa Cruz without giving you food to eat. That is it. Amen. But I am a person, let me read that one first. I don't like to eat from anybody. I always said to Brother Carlton, it is all right. I am all right. Amen. And from there, Brother Carlton, understand me. I work with, beside Brother Carlton, Dumdoro. It is also Brother Thorpe. All of us work down here. And I was in the middle. Because the area that I work on, it belongs to Deacon Lawman. So I was in the middle of all of these men down there. And I work along come in, and they look after lunch, and they call me my daily food. I don't want no food. No food. Reason for that. Until now I have that problem. I don't like to eat from person. I don't know. They hear miss you. Alright, but you know, I eat from you. But one day, down in Durham, Brother Carlton is put on a pot down there. And brother, when I look at the food, I have to eat the food. I have to eat the food. Amen. And that is the first one, and I think it is the last one I eat from Brother Carlton Dixon. And I remember Brother Carlton Dixon look after some torture and some sad year. And brother, the food look good. We have to eat some of it. Have eat some of the food. Amen. That is Brother Carlton. So whenever time you look after food in your room, it better you don't eat it, but it's going to run. It's going to call you for the food. Right? Was really, really a good man to me. I don't know for nobody else. Right? But Brother Dixon, he was a good man to me. And one of the time he grabbed me. And he said, why? You don't know that people don't pump. And pumpers. Nappy. Nappy, something like that. Nappy. You don't know that? Let me put that nappy body. Yeah, boy, you see me? Right? Anyway, that's Brother Carlton. I heard somebody say that for 93. Well, I don't think we have nothing to regret. Amen. Well, we understand. Monsieur, we understand. We understand when, you know, when one have to part. But then said, man have to part. Huh? And father have to part. And husband have to part. One day. But sister, listen. Hold the feet. Hold the feet. Don't let it go. Hold it. Amen. I don't finish anything about this whole finish. I have been to Canada for the first time, and I don't know nothing about Canada. Amen. But let me tell you something that when I reach Canada, somebody is here telling me, though. Right? You know what happened when I came off of the plane? Everything was intact for me. I have my shoes ready. I have my coat ready. And everything just ready for me in the cold. Who you think provide that? Vinette, God bless you. Always smiling like Brother Carlton. Always. God bless you, ma'am. God bless you and keep you and cause his face to shine upon you. More song, please. Thank you. All right. And then afterward, we will invite us to food at our house. Lord Jesus, if you see food, we will get such a belly to eat food. Eh? Sister, Vinette, God bless you. Glad for you, just about everything. Keep the faith. Keep the faith, don't give up. God bless you, all of you, and to do you good. Carlton is blessed. Can somebody praise the Lord? I repeat, Carlton is blessed. You don't have to fret for him. He's blessed. Amen. Brother Carlton, he died on his bed. Am I right, sister? Listen. He died on his bed. He's blessed. The last time I went there to have a meeting with him, the little said he won't talk one bit. But when he hears that Pastor Allen is here, he opened up his eyes. And he started, he sing with us, the chorus that we were singing. Amen. And then he went back, he closed his eyes. Amen. On his bed. What I said, on his bed. Amen. It's a blessing when you can lay on your bed. None of God's disciples, you can name them, none, and none of God's disciples die on their bed. None of them. Amen. None of them died on their bed. And they were real men of God. The only disciple that we don't know what happened to him, how he died, is John. That is, if he died, we don't know. But all of the disciples died out there. Some different death took a hold of them. When you think of Paul, the man of God, praise God, who after God spoke to him and tell him, said, all right, you've been a chosen vessel. Right? He never died on his bed. Didn't die on his bed either. Right? But we rather to obey God more than man. Praise God. And you look at his disciples, I mean his son, and he said, my son Timothy, I am now ready to go. He died as a champion. He died as a champion. Praise him, the Lord. Amen. No. Paul said, I have fought a good fight. Amen. 90 and what? At 3 years of age, I have fought a good fight. And I've kept what? The faith. And now I am sure that I am sure that what? A crown of is awaiting me. Why? Because I died as a champion. I found a good fight. I get me out sometime, but I'm back in the race. And now lay up for me a what? Crown of righteousness. God bless you. I'm going to hand it back to my, because it's many people ready to go. You can't get that good fight, that good fight. That is never ready to go in. God bless.
We have been acquainted with Brother Dixon, and more so Sister Dixon. Praise God. I don't usually go to person's house if I don't have a specific reason to do so. But Sister Dixon's house is one of the houses that I would, I don't know, maybe it's because she's so close down the road to me. She's my neighbor. So from time to time, I would drop by and have conversation with Sister and Brother Dixon. I remember when I just came to Warsop and I was working in Westmoreland, and one evening I came home and Pastor Allen had gone out and I could not go into the house, and I went back to Sister Dixon and she put me to bed. and she was disappointed when Pastor Allen came, so I had to go home. Amen? Praise God. So I know that they are good people to deal with, and I know that Brother Colin loved the village to his heart. Praise God. I remember when they came and we happened to pass by the day, and I said to him, I said, so the princess called. He said, who? He said, Billy, there. He said, there. We said, yes, Billy, there. And he became so chirpy because he heard Billy's name. I know that she but you still have your mother, so cheer up. Amen? Don't be too discouraged. Praise God. Can we just bow our heads in the presence of the Lord tonight? Praise God. God and Father, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we give you honor, we give you glory, and we give you praise. We just want to thank you tonight for being so, so good to us. We are so grateful for the life of our brother, a life that has been well lived. And we thank you tonight. Thank you for the children. Thank you for the wife. Thank you for all the family who are here tonight. Thank you for all the brethren. Thank you for all the friends and the neighbors and the community people and all of the lives that he has impacted. Lord, and as we go, help us, Lord, that we will take a page out of his book. And that may the life that we live, oh God, let it speak for us. Let our lives be a testament. Let our lives be a testimony of who we really and truly are. God, and as we go tonight, will you just go with us? Will you bless us? Will you throw your arms around us? And will you keep us safe, Lord, until the storm passes by? Take full control, Lord, and we give you the honor tonight, we give you the glory, and we give you the praise, and we just want to say thank you, Lord, for all that you have done, for what you are doing, and for what you are about to do, as we place ourselves into your hands and into your care, in Jesus' name we pray, amen. Lord, bless you all, thank you all for coming. And we're looking forward to having a catawampus time on Saturday, God's willing. Don't come with your tears. Cry if you need to cry before you come on Saturday. Because we want to have a time of, a hallelujah time, a time of rejoicing. Praise God. We want to have a convocation as we send home our brother in time. God bless you in Jesus' name. And now may the same. Jesus comes. Amen. The Lord bless you all. Walk on.
Living wife Eunice, 6 children, grandchildren, adopted daughter, and other relatives. The body of Carlton Hugh Dixon leaves Robinson's funeral home to Warsop United Pentecostal Church on Saturday, June 8th, for funeral service at 11. Interment in the church cemetery.